Well, this is what is termed secondary woodland, semi-ancient secondary woodland. And it's not ancient. Up on top is Everson Woods, and that's an ancient woodland, so it's always been woodland, as far as you can tell. You can tell that by a lot of different things, by the ground flora. There's certain flora in ancient woodlands that doesn't exist anywhere else. It cannot exist anywhere else. And some of those are mosses, and in this one, it's all very common mosses. So. And also that I know now that this was a medieval village here.
These worms, that's Brachythecium. That's quite Rutabulum. Although they all change their names these days. That one. This one.
You've got this long, if you just get to see it, it's got a very long leaf. And it's undulated, that's why it's called undulatum. So mostly find that, Eurynchium, Brachythecium. So what we've done is I've got to actually bring out all the timber. Because our tractor broke and I couldn't fix it for the last winter to take the timber crane, we couldn't get in to get the stuff out. He is just seriously strong. Come on, John. This is the one that broke all my ribs. I brought food in to feed him in the winter and he just get excited and he just kicked up and he just unfortunately caught me right there and he busted about two or three ribs. I just couldn't hardly breathe, but there's nothing they can do. But no, he's a good horse. Powerful. I'm gonna have to break him in slowly into the woodland work. Aren't ya? Nice. Look, you can see all those leaves dying on there? It looks like it's got the ashback dieback disease. We did all the ash and to break up the lines, but also to get the oak to grow, because they were dying out because the oak ash was overtopping it and killing it from a light point of view. But then you had to deal with deer. This will be fallow deer. That's a lot of growth, and I think that's 2 years old. I mean, you think about it, it's one of the hardest jobs to do is forestry work. Because there just isn't no money in it. You don't get subsidised the same as agriculture. The only things I get is money for the work I do, and that's only half the payment. And in many cases, it doesn't cover half the cost. On the one hand, if we cut and provide access for the public and pick up their litter, we get paid per day, roughly-ish, for a man to pick litter up, and it's your best guess actually. It takes about 2 days, or let's say 4 visits in a year to pick up the litter throughout the woods, you know, along the tracks. And then you might get a bit of brashing to keep so they can do that, and then you get mowing the rides for wildlife as well. So there's access, there's wildlife, and there's archaeology. And one at the moment that's quite good is the culling of the wood deer. They actually pay quite a bit of money for that. It takes quite a bit of time. So actually we get, that's the only thing where it does actually help. That, in fact, culling the deer is about 1/3 of the yearly income from grants culling them out. I have to say, I'd be quite happy and I could be warm enough using a few twigs in that lorry. And that's because that'd be efficient. And this is on the floor. You wouldn't want to use all the wood up because look, there's fungi on there, there's insects that go in there. And you wouldn't want to clean it absolutely clean. However, that is a very odd thing because in the, before fossil fuel and coal came along, in Cambridgeshire, there were lots of instances where there wouldn't be any wood on the floor because that's all they had for cooking with and heating. And most of that's for cooking. So, there wouldn't an awful lot actually, and still the wildlife was about. So it's a bit of a conundrum really. And you go to the desert, and I've been in the desert, and I got castigated, or got really told off for excessive use of wood. And you won't believe it, it can't have been that much. And it was because it was in the desert, it just wasn't much of it, it was like precious. And because I come from here, I had a sort of Western attitude to like, oh, no, just burn it. And I got told off quite badly. And then, you know, you then realise that actually how wasteful the Western world is actually compared to other places in the world that don't have very much. So you take fossil fuel away. I mean, there's a good reason why there weren't many woods left by the 13th century. It was all used up. People should become more aware of fossil fuel because you're using it now very greedily, but you are using up. So what you're using now, you could stretch for another 1,000 years, but no, you're using it up really greedily and you're not taking account that your generations in the future. And yeah, you need to find systems where we can get energy from that aren't going to cost the earth. And from my point of view, I can't see where I get any the amount of energy I need unless I develop that for the population. And you go, well, I've got sheep, and then you got your wheat. And so, you know, in the old days, you had to keep some sheep, and you couldn't kill them all, and you had to keep some wheat to grow. And you had to keep some back just for insurance in case your crop wasn't that good. So you built in some safety factors. Now people wouldn't think like that. Most people wouldn't think like that. They'll go, well, I've got to eat now. And they'd eat it and they'd forget that they've actually got to have some of that to grow for next year because there won't be any otherwise. They'd eat all the sheep up. Once they've eaten all the sheep, I can't grow any more sheep. The mentality would be, and it's what happens to the great orc, you know, because the people go, well, if I don't have it, somebody else is going to have it. So it's mutual destruction. And in a way, that's the same thing what happened to Little Orc for him or her or it, is that because it got rare and rare and all the museums wanted one, they killed the last one for the museum. They didn't think about breeding them. Okay, we got more. No. That's the last one. Well, I've got to have it in my museum. So that was the end of that great orc, extinct.